fans that they vent their frustrations. Chad, what's the first email?
First email is from a local basketball fan.
Okay.
His question is, will the Miami Heat make the playoffs this year?
No, that's an embarrassing question, Chad. No, they're not going to make the playoffs because Dwayne Wade can never step up.
I'm talking about
Dwayne Wade needs to act like Kobe Bryant. He needs to act like a LeBron James.
He's
never done it.
He can. He has done it.
I love Dwayne Wade.
He has done it.
When has
he done
it? He
never came back last year.
They won a championship.
The year won a championship.
He had a real bad injury. He came back when he wasn't supposed to come back.
I understand
that's the
that.
Problem. He should have never came back.
That's why. But
I see at home.
He's improving. He's getting back into the floor again. I see that.
I see the way they win the championship.
I see that Wade coming back.
You don't say comments.
I see
comments.
Him coming back.
You don't say comments.
I see him coming back.
When you're in the elite.
And when Wade
wants
to put the Heat on his shoulders, they win a championship like they did that year.
You can't put the Heat on her shoulders.
I'm not saying they're going to win a championship. They will make the playoffs this year.
That's the problem. She never came back in the first place.
First of all, Miami is like 26 losses right now. Okay, they're going. All right.
Okay. All right. So give me the eight Eastern teams that will make the playoffs, minus the Miami Heat.
The Celtics.
You know what? I don't have the first damn clue.
The Pistons.
I don't have the first damn clue. But it says right now.
The Wizards.
I'm not gonna sit here and name teams. No. I'm not gonna do that. Sit here and name
teams.
Yeah,
because you can't.
No, I'm not.
You can't.
I don't want.
Because you can't.
It's a waste of my time.
Because you cannot. Because the Miami Heat will make the playoffs. That's why.
I can't do it.
That's why you can't name them. That is why you cannot name them. Because Miami will make the playoffs.
This is right now.
You cannot name eight teams from the Eastern Conference that will make
the best quarterback in the NFL.
Yo, the playoffs over Miami.
Okay, it's too late. I'm not saying maybe it's too late.
OJ
January right now.
What does that mean?
It's too late to make a.
Then give me the eight teams.
It's too late to turn around.
Give me the eight teams. Give
I'm
me
not
the eight
gonna,
teams.
I'm not gonna give.
How about you guys huddle up? Give me the eight teams.
I'm not gonna give you the eight teams.
Come on, eight teams. Because you can't.
No, it's wasting my time.
Because you can't. Because you can't. That's it.
It's wasting my time.
You can't.
I'm just saying. It's too late
to Miami.
No, hold on. It's too late to turn around. Corey Bryant, when this team was falling, he would step up and he would give you a 50-point performance. Dwayne Wade can't do it.
Dwayne Wade is hurt.
How
he
many
can do it. He can do it.
And Dwayne Wade had his career.
And he can do it. He can do it.
Well, you know what?
He doesn't have to score 50 points.
Why doesn't he?
Because he has Shaq.
You just said
he's 75.
Shaq.
45.
Shaq has presence.
Hold on.
Shaq has presence and he's going to get to the line.
Power forward.
He's going to get you at least 15.
He averages 12.
He's going to get you at least 15.
He's your pro. Please.
He's going to give you at least 15.
On a great night.
Wait.
On a great night.
Oh, no.
On a great night.
Don't say that.
On a great night.
Don't say that.
15 and 11.
Don't say that. On a great night, he'll get 25. He'll get 25. On a great night.
He's had 25 in 3 years.
He'll get 25 on a great night.
Here's the point. Dwayne Wade right now, if he wants to do it, he's a start. I'm talking about literally this week.
And he will.
And I don't think he will.
He will. He will.
Between me and you, I don't think he will.
He will.
Dave, what's the next email?
He will.
Another email from a local basketball fan also.
Some of these local basketball fans.
Lil Timmy.
A Lil Timmy, okay. Where is he from?
His question, he's from Brockton.
Okay.
Local.
We have an email from Lil Timmy from Texas. I thought that was the same one.
His question is, what team is an early disappointment?
Early disappointment has got to be, I was talking to Kyrie Lujan about this between segments, it's got to be the Utah Jazz. Utah Jazz last year won 53 games or something. And this year, I feel like they're getting their best from everyone. They're not sneaking up on people anymore. They're not sneak up on nobody.
I think the main issue is their defense. I mean, you're getting the stats you're gonna get from Carlos Boozer and Deron Williams and even Carol Anko. Like everybody's putting their part. I think it's just the defense is just absolutely falling apart.
Team defense.
And that's the problem. It's just team defense, and they're just getting outran. And it's just, you know, they need to pick it up.
And so right now, Deron Williams and Carlos Boozer start playing all stars. Right now, they're playing like good.
They are playing like all stars. No. Deron Williams just had 15 and 20 the other night, but I'm just throwing that out there.
Yeah, he did have 15 and 20. Sometimes when you're a great player, like allegedly, like he thinks he wants to be a great point guard, you're going to need more performances like that. Period.
Exactly.
You're going to need more performances like that.
I mean, he's about third in the league in assists right now. I think the main issue, honestly, I think Jerry Sloan's losing his players. You know, and you don't want to say that about a coach, but I think it's just time to, I mean, sometimes you got to hang it up. You know, it's like you need a new coach. This is a new era of basketball. People want to run, and he's still a half-court coach. And, like, the main problem is he's trying to morph them into John Stockton and Karl Malone, and you can't play like that in this era. Like, you need to be able to run the floor, especially in the Western Conference. Like, you've seen teams are much faster now in the Western Conference, even though it's surrounded by big men, but teams are much faster with Phoenix and Golden State. Like, teams are faster now, so... I mean, you got to be able to run, and I mean, maybe it's just time for Jerry Sloan to call it quits.
Chad, your thoughts?
Well, my disappointing team of this year has to be Houston Rockets.
Yeah.
Before the season started, I was sold on this team. Heard about the trade with Steve Francis and everything. Steve Francis, Tracy McGrady, Yao Ming. I thought it was going to be, they were going to have a great team. I thought it was going to put in a lot of work this year. And they've
Steve
done
Francis
nothing.
Still in rehab.
Steve no. Francis is on the bench getting water for Tracy McGrady and Yao Ming. All right? He came to camp out of shape. The coach does not want to play him, and he's no help to them. They got him for nothing.
The problem
and Tracy McGrady is overrated. He's not helping his team.
I agree.
Very true. His team. I mean, they have a better record than the Knicks, but they're looking like the Knicks of the West.
He's not helping his team.
You have Rafer Austin, your starting point guard, who's very streaky. I mean, he's coming off of, like, three charges in the summertime. Like, I mean, you gotta get a hold of your players, you need a better supporting cast.
Here's the point. Let's look at the facts. They have no point guard. They got no point guard to give Tracy McGrady and Yami. They're making Tracy McGrady and Rafer Austin, Steve Francis. Those are all two guards. Tracy McGrady's having a
you know
two
what the problem is? You know what the problem
he's a small
is?
Forward.
I think they're all reliant on Tracy McGrady to be that playmaker, to get the ball, look for the players, score at will, but he's not doing that.
And he doesn't have
the personality
to do it.
And he's getting the ball, everybody's sitting around watching him.
He's not a player.
He's not getting the offense started.
Chad, listen, he has the Dwayne Wade personality of he can't step up and go to the next level.
He
doesn't have the Kobe Bryant, I'm going to score 50 points.
He does not.
In the fourth quarter to help my team win.
He does not.
Doesn't have that personality.
He has to stay healthy.
Yeah, he has to stay healthy, but he can't.
Exactly.
And if you always interrupt
that.
Do not
put Wade and Tracy McGrady in the same category.
I'll put them
in.
I'm doing it.
I think they're going to the same category. You need to cut that out.
And he needs to stop.
That's all I'm going to say.
Yeah.
I mean,
yeah. You can't do that. You can't do that.
I'm not sold on Dwayne Wade this year yet, but he does have an NBA championship.
Wade does not play when he feels like it.
True.
So?
And he plays defense.
Who cares?
And he's a playmaker.
No, he's not a playmaker.
Yes, he is a playmaker.
If he was a playmaker,
Dwayne
Wade
is a playmaker.
They'd be a better team right now if he was a playmaker.
He really has nobody.
Kobe Bryant has nobody.
Kobe Bryant has some players. They're stepping up. The Lakers are stepping up this year.
Okay, let's say
the Lakers are stepping up this year.
Kobe has nobody. LeBron has nobody. And then bring him to the NBA Finals.
LeBron has nobody.
Dwayne Wade has
Ilgauskas.
Dwayne Wade has
yes.
Dwayne Wade has more help.
Very underrated.
Dwayne Wade has more help than LeBron. Ilgauskas is garbage.
Daniel Gibson.
If I remember correctly, the Cleveland Cavaliers had the best scoring front line in the NBA last year.
Because LeBron James makes them better.
All right, you can say that, but they still have the talent. They're still giving him something.
Yeah, they are.
They're giving him something.
Line,
but
not enough.
The best scoring something. Front line in the NBA. You can't go wrong with that. That's exactly why they was in the finals last year.
40 minutes and give you a maximum of 5 points and 2 rebounds.
Mark my words.
Maximum.
Cleveland's turning around.
Ilgauskas?
Exactly.
Cleveland is turning
five
around.
5 points?
5 points and 2 rebounds.
Absolutely.
Way too inconsistent.
I want to see the stats on that.
It's all up here.
No, it's not.
It's all up here.
Now, my early disappointment. My early disappointment has to be the Denver Nuggets.
Real quick, we got about a
minute. They're not playing any defense. The return of Kenyon Martin has been absolutely non-effective. There's no bench play. And all the offense is coming from Carmelo and Iverson. You can't complain with those players. They're doing what they're supposed to do on that team. They're scoring. Iverson dishing out the ball. But they're not playing any defense at all. Kenyon Martin's ineffective. Marcus Camby, who's arguably one of the best defenders in the NBA. I mean, he's just not a scoring threat. So, I mean, that's my disappointment.
Yeah, I agree. Denver's got to be disappointed,
yeah,
too.
Yeah, they're just not an all-around team. They're just not playing defense and offense, not running, they're not doing everything you need to be doing to be successful, especially in the West.
I agree. That is it for our second segment of Stepping Up Big Time and Lost Translation. We'll be back in the second segment. Chad will join us, and Kyrie Lewis Jr. will be making his return. And with some freestyle, we'll talk about anything we want to talk about.